What's up, guys? Dr. Megan Hirsch here from Movement RX. We are the movement specialists and physical therapists for CrossFitters. So today we are going to talk about crossover symmetry. So we've been working with a bunch of different tools for strengthening, rehabbing, dealing with pain in different areas. And today we're going to talk about crossover symmetry, which is a really good tool for warming up the shoulders and the upper body, injury prevention, as well as decreasing shoulder pain and shoulder asymmetry. So as a PT, I see a lot of shoulder pain and mobility issues, as well as strength and stability issues with CrossFitters. We're doing a lot of overhead movements. You've got the jerk, you've got the snatch, pull-ups, you name it. So what I see a lot are these shoulder dyskinesias. And basically what that is the rotator cuff and the scapular muscles, for the most part, aren't engaging or are weaker than the rest of the shoulder girdle. So this is Fat Tony. He is my demo athlete here at CrossFit Long Beach. So basically the shoulder girdle is made up of four joints. You've got the sternoclavicular right here. You've got the AC joint. We've got the glenohumeral joint here, which is a ball and socket joint. So it looks something like this from the inside. And then you've also got your sternothoracic right here. So with the glenohumeral joint, a lot of what can go wrong is you've got this posterior cuff right here. So rotator cuff muscles start to get weakened. You start to get an internally rotated shoulder. The other thing is a lot of these scapular muscles back here, they're either asymmetrical on each side or they're weak compared to the front. So Tony, Fat Tony, I'm sorry, I'm gonna have you turn away from the camera, and I want you to abduct your shoulders. So palms forward and go overhead. Good. So as you can see here, his right side sort of has a little pause and then it goes out. Let's go again. Good. So this side is not going at the same speed as the left side. Come on down. Great, okay. All right, so why is this so important? So Fat Tony here has some shoulder pain and on his right side. So what happens when these muscles aren't working properly, it creates an impingement. So he's a little internally rotated here, might cause some anterior shoulder pain. There also can be some issues with the posterior cuff here. So basically the rotator cuff and the scapular muscles need to be firing equally and need to be strong in order to get the shoulder and the glenohumeral joint overhead pain-free. So I'm gonna show you on Tony some of these exercises that we can do. So go ahead and grab here for me. Okay, so I'm gonna have him do a basic row. So I'm just gonna have you pull it to your chest. Good. So now I'm going to have you do the WY negative. So you're going to pull it into your chest, into a Y, and then overhead. Okay. And I'm going to have you do another one. We're going to watch what this is doing to his shoulder blades, how it's activating those muscles back here. Go again. Great. So as you can see on that, his shoulder blades were activating a lot more symmetrical and balanced with the exercise and the crossover symmetry. All right, so that's just one of the shoulder issues that I see that we just talked about. We went over one or two exercises you can do with crossover symmetry. For those of you that don't have it in your gym already, it comes with this little handy guide of different exercises you can use. So go check out gocrossover.com. If you have any other questions about movement or physical therapy, movement-rx.com. See you next time.